The very warmest of welcomes to you indeed to the FIG Trampoline Gymnastics World Championships taking place at the Arena Birmingham. The men's double mini trampoline final is about to get underway.
Here it comes.
The women's trampoline team final is the next event to take place at the 36th FIG Trampoline Gymnastics World Championships in Birmingham. The teams that have made it into this women's trampoline final, huge congratulations to the Georgians, who had a great qualification campaign. They are in as the fourth best in qualification, the top performers in the preliminary round, unsurprisingly, the People's Republic of China by a long way. Sorry, five gymnasts in each of the three rounds is what I meant to say. Melania Rodriguez of Spain. The Spaniards were the fifth best overall in qualification for this final. And Rodriguez was their top performer. 53.68 was her best number. Gets through all 10 skills and gets a secure number on the board for the Spaniards. What an excellent day she's having, having just taken the double mini trampoline world championship title. 52.75. Léa Labrousse of France, the European Games champion in 2019. A gymnast who was seventh in the individual final at the last World Championship. This is her eighth time competing at the World Championships. I think that one we a seasoned performance from Léa Labrousse, absolutely secure.
Very strong routine, two triples in that routine, so element one and element three.
53.92. Léa Labrousse, close to her best in qualification and the strongest we've seen so far. Now then, best performers in qualification. This is Zhu Shuiying, the reigning Olympic champion. What a way to start. Her best score in qualification, 56.34. The first trampoline gymnast ever to convert youth Olympic gold to senior Olympic gold. Oh my goodness me, she's very close. She made light work of a very difficult moment in that routine, the Olympic champion. And that is how she has established herself as the absolute finest. What was interesting watching that is there wasn't a move at all from the coach with the mat, suggesting that he knew she was going to get out of that situation very comfortably. And he was right. 55.85, the best that we've seen. So these are the standings at the moment. China leading, then France, then Spain. So the big movers, Spain in that first round, they were the fifth best qualifiers at the expense of the Canadians. They've swapped positions with them. What a good start from the Spaniards. Third place after the first round. This is Noemi Romero, the 23-year-old from Madrid at her fifth World Championships. She actually started in karate. Her coach was ill, replaced by another who set up a trampolining session. The rest was history. Of the apparatus there, Noemi Romero. Looked like she had to improvise a little and sacrifice some difficulty in order to keep on the apparatus, but she did it. A very wise move from Romero. 52.72. Laura Paris from France. The 31-year-old, it's her third World Championships, her first since Denmark in 2015. It is wonderful that she's back, and this is the first time that she has ever made a final at World Championship level. Congratulations to her. Perseverance in this sport. Laura Paris making it to her first ever World Championship final at 31. I mean, Pete, that is a brilliant accomplishment. That's a good number. 53.34 for Laura Paris. That's the best she's produced at these championships. Fan Xinyi, the 21-year-old youth Olympic champion from Buenos Aires in 2018. She was part of the team that won this title a year ago. The Chinese in pole position after round one, as you would expect. I think we can say with confidence that the People's Republic of China will be retaining top spots after the second round, courtesy of Fan Xinyi. Great performance from her. 55.66. Excellent first two rounds from the Chinese. They've set it up beautifully for Hu Yicheng. China with 10 out of 10 so far. France in second place. The Spaniards still doing very well to be third. Georgia the most likely to make a challenge to them now. Luba Golovina competed at the World Championships in Birmingham in 2011. Her young teammates have set her up brilliantly. She now follows Mariam Ragimovi and Anano Apakidze. Absolutely terrific from the veteran. Now then, the Georgians, who've never won a medal ever at the World Championships of Trampoline Gymnastics, they might need a favour from the Canadians in terms of them finishing above the Spaniards. But Golovina has done very well here. Very. 54.68. The Georgians now are dreaming of being on the podium, and they may well see their dreams become reality. Sophie Anne Metto of Canada, the 25-year-old from Quebec, her sixth consecutive World Championships, and she was the individual silver medalist in 2017. fiercely high quality from Sophie Anne Metteaux. From a horizontal displacement point of view, very secure. She was as high as 55.24 in qualification. 55.11. Very good number that for the Canadians. Now then, to win this, the People's Republic of China. The gymnast tasked with taking the world championship title is Hu Yicheng. China have been magnificent from start to finish. First to Zhu Shuiying, then Fan Xingyi, then Hu Yicheng. That was just superb from the top qualifiers and the reigning world champions. It's another great number for China, 56.02. They have won this so comfortably. They picked up the maximum 15-point haul. The French have won a medal. They've taken second place, and for the first time ever, Georgia has won a medal at the World Championships of Trampoline Gymnastics. The classified results in the women's trampoline team final. The Georgians ahead of Spain for bronze on the countback system. France taking the silver medal. And the People's Republic of China winning every single round to defend their title from 2022. The People's Republic of China, the world champions. And they're joined by their fellow medalists in the women's trampoline team competition. Huge congratulations to Zhu Shuiying, Fan Xingyi, Hu Yicheng, and Cao Yunju.
Once again, let's make some noise for our World Championship medalists.
非常开心，非常激动吧。然后能够延续去年，就是再一次登上这个领奖台，我觉得非常高兴。
Very happy and excited because this is our second time since last year. So we're so happy to bring home the second, you know.
其实我觉得我们每个人就是可能最需要的就是做好自己需要做的，然后相信队友。
对，然后我们一直以一个像巡姐一榜样，就是怎么说？以老带新吧，
We're on the national team, like being teammates for 3 years, and we have a role model here, this big sister and this younger sisters, and so for later, for the near future is obviously Paris Olympics, so we are gearing up for the Olympic Games.
The men's trampoline team final. The five nations that have made it through. The finalists in the men's team trampoline competition. We'll start with the host nation, the fifth best in qualifying. And the end of each round will bring us the Portuguese. We begin the men's team trampoline final at the Birmingham 2023 World Championships. This is Andrew Stamp of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland, the first British trampoline gymnast to win a Youth Olympic medal. That was in 2018, and he won a team all-around world title last year in Sofia, Bulgaria. Contact right at the very end there as he came to land. That's very important. Good start from the British team. They were the fifth best in qualification. The best scoring qualification for Andrew Stamp was 58.8. He's very close to it. 58.57.
France, Julien Chartier.
To France and Julien Chartier a year ago. Seeing in the men's team trampoline final, all of these nations keeping themselves in contention as we go into round number two. Very tight early on, but that's a great start from the French, Julien Chartier, 58.76. Just below 0.2 better than Andrew Stamp. 30-year-old born in the United States of America, a two-time Olympian. It's been not the easiest of days for him in terms of Olympic qualification. And here he is at his 10th World Championships. One of the masters, and that was a veteran's performance from Diogo Abreu. That's an excellent score, 59.51. The Portuguese, the top performers in round one. Portugal, the top qualifiers and reigning world champions, winning round one. France, second. Great Britain, the big movers. They are the big movers because they were the fifth best in qualification. Zach Pazamanos of Great Britain, the 20-year-old from Merseyside. He's the reigning British champion. Respected young man. Brilliant. 59.82. One of the real veterans of the sport. 29-year-old Alain Morant of France. An Olympian from Tokyo. This is his 8th World Championships. And he was the individual silver medalist. And the team silver medalist with his colleagues last year in Sofia.
It's a privilege to see him live. That is just stunning.
60.27, the score we've seen so far. The Portuguese, this is Pedro Ferreira. He's another veteran. It's his 8th World Championships. For a very, very interesting final round in this men's team final. That was Pedro Ferreira of Portugal and we've got one more now for each team to go. 58.71. That makes for a most interesting leaderboard. With one round to go, the picture is this. France leading, Portugal and Great Britain on the same number of points. Spain are in fifth position. The USA really now regrettably are out of the chase, but the rest of them are all viable contenders. It's going to be good fun. Ruben Padilla of the United States of America, the reigning two-time champion of the world in the double mini event. He was a mixed bag in qualification, 58.1 and 50.78. A lot for the United States of America to get onto the podium, but he's finished their team effort off really well. Ruben Padilla on what's been a very successful evening session of competition for him. He's making a lot of noise in the world of double mini trampoline. Ruben Padilla, twice the world champion. His score, 57.62. And what that does is put the USA's performance in this round ahead of the performance of Great Britain. Robert Villarasao of Spain. From Artes, a town in the Barcelona region. 22-year-old who is a student of education at the University of Barcelona. Control. Robert Villarasao glances up into the rafters and looks quite composed at the end of that. They look nervous as anything, his teammates. His best scoring qualification was 57.42. He's got very close to it, 57.37. Pierre Guzou of France. He produced two routines that were in the mid-58s in qualification. He was part of the team that won the silver medal that's now going for gold a year later. It's not catastrophic, but it is a little costly there. The ending for Pierre Guzou, 56.65. It is a drop of about two marks from his qualification displays. The classified results in the men's trampoline team final. Bronze to the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland. Silver to the Spaniards. And the champions of the world, a year on from taking silver, the French. The medalists in the men's team trampoline competition at the World Championships in Birmingham.
Yeah, we are so excited because the last world title for French was in 1996. So we are really excited with this medal, and 30 minutes before the girls won the silver medal, so we wanted to do the same, and now we have the gold medal, so yeah, we are so happy with this. Yeah. Last year we won the silver medal, so yeah, we wanted to to improve or do the same, yeah. But every medal is great, so even a bronze medal was correct, and we won the gold medal, so yeah, we are so happy with this. We don't celebrate too much tonight, so tomorrow we can support our friend for synchro final, so yeah, let's go French team.
What?
Let's go!
Let's go!